The new SmartThings Tracker will help you find your stuff. What makes it different from other tracking devices is that it does not rely only on Bluetooth. It uses Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and LTE-M, which allows it to track items indoors and outdoors while conserving battery life. But before we dig in, let's talk requirements. First of all, you need to buy the device, which sells for $99. The initial fee includes a year of service, and once that expires, you'll pay $5 per month or $50 annually. The service is currently provided by AT&T, with Verizon launching later this year, but you don't have to have cellular service with either company in order to use the device. You do have to be in the US, however, as it only works on US networks. A SmartThings hub is also not a necessity, but Tracker works with V2, V3, SmartThings Wi-Fi hubs, the ADT Smart Security Panel, and Connect Home hubs. I tested it with both V2 and V3, and there were no differences in performance. Finally, you will need the new SmartThings Connect app, as it doesn't work with SmartThings Classic. Setting the device up is simple. If you turn Tracker on before opening the Connect app, you'll receive an automated message prompting you to connect the device and tie it to a location. If not, head to the Device tab, touch the plus sign, and select Tracker once it appears. After that, simply follow the on-screen instructions. The only problem I had during setup was that Tracker kept attaching to the wrong hub because it was attaching to my default location. You can change your default location using a SmartThings IDE login, so I'll drop instructions for doing that below, but for now, let's talk about tracking. First, I tried to track it by asking a friend to hide Tracker at a couple of indoor locations. All Tracker can do is show the last known estimated address of your tracker on demand, which it does with decent accuracy, but an estimated address doesn't tell you that much. Generally speaking, cheap Bluetooth trackers are better at finding items indoors, as they're often equipped with things like alarms or proximity sensors that can really help you hone in on an item. All things a tracker is lacking, which is why I'm giving it a thumbs down for indoor tracking. Of course, if I was trying to find something larger than Tracker, like a car or a person, I might have had better luck, which is why the device is more useful when tracking items outdoors, but there is a catch. Tracker can't map the device's location in real time. The best way to track something is to press the live tracking button. This option will update the device's location once per minute for 10 minutes. By pressing the travel path button, you can also view the device's most recent travel path and scroll through to see where it was at different points in time. Alternatively, you can set up automatic location updates from the settings menu. This option will automatically ping the device's location at set intervals, with the shortest interval being 10 minutes. Of course, if you're trying to track an item, every 10 minutes is even less useful than every minute, which is why outdoor tracking gets a maybe you should buy it, depending on what you're trying to do. Personally, I would not trust it to track a child or a pet. Maybe you could use it to keep tabs on where you parked your car, but keep in mind that tracking a moving vehicle or tracking from a moving vehicle is basically impossible. The device is dust and water resistant, so you can use it outside, but of course you can do more than track. So let's talk about that. First, Tracker can send notifications. You simply press the power button twice, which sends the device's location to your SmartThings app. Second, you can set two geofence locations. For example, you might set one around your home and one around your child's school. Third, Tracker can be used as an arrival sensor, which means that you can use it in automations. From the automations tab, click the plus button, select the location Tracker is attached to, and then custom automation. You'll see a condition here called based on a member's location, but for me, this only works with my phone, so I ended up using the option labeled as based on device status. From here, select your tracker, and then you can choose enter or leave zone. If you want, you can add even more conditions, like only if it's between 11 a.m. and 12 p.m. on a Tuesday or Thursday. And then we can add another condition, like my security mode is disarmed. Under that, you can choose from notify me, control a device, and change this location's mode. And again, you can choose multiple actions like change mode to away and turn off the lights. Finally, from the app, you can press the top button to toggle between street and satellite view, or you can click on the date, which drops down and allows you to view your location's history by day. I think the bottom line here is that I'm not overly enthusiastic about the tracker, but I'm also not opposed to it. It really just depends on why you want to use it. If you have any questions about Tracker, let me know in the comments section below. And before you go, subscribe and check out my other SmartThings videos, and I will see y'all soon.